Everyone has been focusing on Cardano lately, and now many people are overlooking Ethereum and a couple of major announcements that just came out, which I think could easily propel Ethereum's price to well over $10,000 per coin and very quickly.
You know, I think Ethereum right now has an advantage over Bitcoin because as more people get into NFTs, all they're going to know is Ethereum. If I decide I like digital art, how do I buy digital art?
With Ether.
Yeah. And if there's thousands of people a day, 2,000 people a day coming in, that's impactful because every now and then one of them is going to be a whale and they're going to buy 1,000 Ether because they want to go out there and be able to buy that big artwork.
All right. So Ethereum's price has rallied well above 300% in 2021. But now a couple of major things have changed. We've seen a dramatic increase in interest in NFTs, which directly benefits Ethereum. We've seen a couple of big announcements with regards to ETH 2.0 and what's been going on with EIP 1559, how much Ethereum has been burned. So in today's video, we're going to talk about everything going on and some of the biggest catalysts for Ethereum right now going to $10,000 per coin. And if you guys enjoy this sort of content, well then please be sure to like the video down below, subscribe to the channel, turn on the bell notifications, and we're still in New York in the apartment. I'm still traveling, still not in my normal place in the normal studio, so we just set up in the apartment. If you don't already have the public.com investing app, make sure to go ahead and follow me on that. You can buy stocks, sell stocks, and see exactly what I'm buying and selling in real time, as well as a full portfolio breakdown. Think of it like an investing app combined with social media. It is completely free to follow me. Use the code Michael when you sign up and you'll get up to $50 in a free stock. But anyways, let's start off by going over a couple of things going on with the overall crypto market and technical indicators with Ethereum before we get into the major catalysts going on. So the first thing is that the global crypto market cap has still been able to maintain its $2 trillion market cap. We've been able to stay above $2 trillion market cap for a little while now. And the interesting thing is here is that Ethereum's price in particular has had a pretty strong support at $3,000 per coin form. You can see over the last couple of weeks, we have seen that Ethereum has stayed well above $3,000 per coin, and we've really just been seeing it in between the $3,000 resistance and the $3,000 support and the $3,300 resistance. So until we could break above $3,300, well, we're not going to see it rally any higher. So that is, you know, the key support and the key resistance, 3,000, 3,300. But with regards to Ethereum, I think we are setting ourselves up to see a massive rally with Ethereum, and many analysts agree. A couple of major analysts and managing director, Megan Casper at Magnetic, she came out and said that Ethereum's price definitely will reach $10,000 per coin this year. That is her price prediction. She says, even though we are seeing it in the low $3,000 per coin range, there are a lot of things going on with EIP 1559, with NFTs, and with a lot of major software upgrades, which are going to help to propel Ethereum's price higher. And the first thing I want to talk about is what she spoke specifically with regards to NFTs, and one thing that not a lot of people give enough credit. So the first thing is with NFTs. Ethereum NFT CryptoPunks just hit a record $1 billion in total sales, and it's not just CryptoPunks. We are seeing this across the entire NFT market. If we look at the top NFTs right now, we could see that CryptoPunks have had over 437,000 total volume for Ethereum. So we've crossed above the $1 billion mark. We're seeing All Art Blocks Curated, another collection, do well over $300 million, about $500 million in total volume as well. And there are a number of projects that have been exploding over the last couple of weeks. In addition to this, we are seeing that the total completed sales in NFTs have been rising dramatically as well. This is a monthly chart, and you could see that we have been steadily increasing over the last 6 months. And between new announcements coming out from Visa buying their own CryptoPunk, Budweiser buying an NFT, between Facebook saying they're getting into the NFT space, which I talked in more detail about in a previous video, all of this has driven more and more people into NFTs. And the reason why this is important for Ethereum is because right now, almost every single person who is gonna go buy an NFT on OpenSea, this is the marketplace for NFTs, one of the major ones, anyone who goes to buy an NFT, 99% of them are going to be using Ethereum right now. If we look at the top projects in terms of like what chains they're on, you could see that All of the top ones are done on Ethereum. CryptoPunks, if you want to buy one, you need to own Ethereum. Artblocks Curated, you need Ethereum. Bored Apes Yacht Club, you need Ethereum. Rarible, Decentraland, CryptoKitties, you need Ethereum for all these different projects. Look at all of these that have Ethereum. So that means every single person who wants to get into the NFT space needs to buy Ethereum, which ultimately is going to create a lot more demand. And we've been seeing steadily that people have actually been taking their Ethereum off of exchanges, meaning that there is less supply available and more demand, because we have seen a dramatic spike in NFTs and demand for them since we have seen these announcements from Visa, Budweiser, and a couple of other major companies. So I think the one thing that we're going to see really help drive Ethereum's price over the next couple of months is going to be specifically with NFTs. As we continue to see more companies come out and say they're buying them, it's going to give people the confidence and the going to give NFTs legitimacy that's going to drive more people to buy Ethereum, so then they could buy NFTs. Mark Cuban has come out and spoke about this multiple times. He said the reason why he loves Ethereum so much is because in order for people to get into NFTs, they need to own Ethereum. We've seen a couple of other people say the same exact thing. While there are a couple of other blockchains that are working on NFTs and start to have a couple of new projects like Cardano with their smart contracts, they have NFTs. Binance Smart Chain, they have NFTs. But for the most part, we are seeing majority of people build their NFTs using the Ethereum chain. So this is very important, something that we cannot overlook, because anyone who wants to buy an NFT is going to buy Ethereum, meaning they're gonna, you know, help to drive the price up. Next thing I want to go over is with regards to EIP 1559 and ETH 2.0. So the crypto analyst from the managing director named Megan Casper, she spoke a little bit about how we're seeing tons of DeFi applications built on Ethereum. And I know a lot of us are bullish on Cardano, talked about Cardano's price and how with smart contracts, there are going to be new projects built on Cardano's blockchain. But the thing that we can't miss is that right now, Ethereum is the clear leader. Ethereum has more projects built on it than any other decentralized finance crypto out there. And with what we're seeing with institutional investors continuing to pour money into Ethereum, this is only going to help extend Ethereum's advantage. Ethereum is currently the number two coin in terms of market cap, and institutional investors are continuing to pick up how much they're investing in it. This is because of what's going on with EIP 1559, because what we have seen is that with EIP 1559, as of right now, there's been over 121,000 Ethereum that has been burned, which is right around $393 million, right around $400 million of Ethereum which has been burned. This is making Ethereum more of a deflationary asset. When you think of Ethereum being burned, just think that these coins are being taken out of the total available supply, meaning that if there's, you know, 121,000 coins being taken out of the supply and miners are only mining, let's say 100,000, well, it starts to become a deflationary asset. So just keep that in mind moving forward, is as we continue to see more and more Ethereum burned, it's going to attract much more institutional investors, and we're going to start to see them pour more money into Ethereum than they are into Bitcoin. And the third thing going on is with regards to ETH 2.0. Right now, ETH 2.0 is scheduled for the first quarter of 2022, and with this, we're going to see Ethereum become significantly more energy efficient with proof of stake. While Cardano is already proof of stake, while Cardano is having the Alonzo upgrade rollout on September 12th, which is going to allow them have smart contracts, ultimately Ethereum has a major advantage because they already have thousands of applications built on the platform. They already have a huge network of NFTs, so many collections. And I think with what is going on with NFT market, what is going on with ETH 2.0 and EIP 1559 with Ethereum being burned, is all going to help propel Ethereum's price significantly higher and attract more institutional investors for just strictly investing in that over Bitcoin. And it's going to attract more people into buying NFTs, which means they need to own Ethereum. So anyways, that's what's going on. It's just something key you need to keep in mind, because anyone who buys an NFT needs to buy Ethereum, and that's going to help drive the price up. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, please be sure to like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.